Yeah, I'm Dr. Venkanna Kannabina. I'm working as assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College, Secunderabad, Telangana. So, in this session, I'm going to discuss about solar cells.
Okay.
Solar cells. So, nowadays, due to drastic before going to the solar cell, how it is working, what are the things? So we will see solar energy is the main power source in present days and future also, because due to drastic changes in environment conditions and also population, there is very difficult to produce the power or electricity using normal or traditional sources like fossil using like that is coal and hydropower and also nuclear power. These are difficult to produce using these sources. So the solar energy is the renewable energy. Until the sun existence, we can produce the solar power using these solar cells. Okay, now we will see the how this solar cell works. Okay, and also we can, by using this solar energy, we can use electricity for many fields like industries and household items, and also you can install these solar panels on the rooftops or parking spaces or also oceans also, that is floating solar cells. We have a lot of advantages, or we can produce the huge power using solar cells. And also present this installation cost is little bit high, but these solar cells we can work like 10 years, 20 years without any cost. Maybe there is very slight maintenance charges, but we can produce huge power using these solar panels. So now we'll discuss what is the solar cells. So this is simple PN junction diode. It converts the optical energy into electrical energy. It is simple PN junction diode. It converts the optical energy or optical signal into electrical energy. Electrical energy. Right? So this is simple PN junction diode, and it converts the optical energy into electrical energy. Now we will see working of this solar cell. Okay, working. Here only three steps are there. For working of the solar cell, first we have to generate the, first step is generate the free charge carriers or free electron holes, or you can say free electron holes. And second step is to separate these generated electron holes. Next step is the separation of these charge carriers. Okay. Third step is collection of, after separation, we have to collect the electrons and holes. That is the collection of charge carriers. Collection of charge carriers. Or electron holes. Whatever you can say. Okay. Here only three steps are involved. First one, we have to generate free electron holes. After that, we have to separate that electron holes and we have to collect that electron holes. Okay, these are the three steps involved in working of solar cells. Okay, so these solar cells mainly use the photovoltaic effect. What is that photovoltaic effect? When you shine the light on some material or semiconductor, if you shine some light on the semiconductor, electrons will be ejected from the material. That is the photovoltaic effect. So electrons will be freed, and these electrons will be free within the material only. This will not come out of the material. That is the photovoltaic effect. Okay. Now we will see that one. Okay, how this will work? We'll see the structure of. So this is the n-type semiconductor. This is n-type, and after that we are having some p-type semiconductor. N-type and p-type semiconductor. After that, here we will coat some TCO layer. Or what is this one? TCO layer or transfer and conducting oxide layer. First we will take n-type material, or n-type semiconductor, either there are many semiconductors are there, you can take, depends on our requirement, we can take n-type semiconductor and after that p-type semiconductor. Then we will code the transfer and conducting oxide layer. I will explain why this layer is important. And after that, there is a metal grids here. Metal grids, these are metal grids. And here also some metal coating is there downside. Okay, here also metal coating and two metal grids are there. So first what we will do, we will shine the light from the solar, from sun, we will shine the light. Okay, we'll shine the light on the semiconductor or this device. So electrons, volts will be generated in the semiconductor, and here because of this junction, the electric internal electric will be formed. The electric field will be separate this electrons one side, volts one side, and electrons opposite side. Using this metal contacts, we'll collect the charge carriers. Separated charge carriers we can connect using this metal contacts, AgR, platinum, gold, depends on requirement we can take. What is the transfer and conducting oxide layer means? This is a dielectric layer. This layer is transparent and highly transparent and conducting also. Why we are using? Because this P and N type semiconductors are not highly conducting materials. These are resistance of these materials is high. So it is very difficult to reach these holes or electron to this semiconductor. So we are using one layer to collect or to transfer the free holes to the this layer or free electrons to the metal contacts. Okay, you can use both sides this TCO layer, but that is the normal structure. You can improve the, you can develop the structure to improve the efficiency of the solar cell. Okay, there are many techniques to fabricate these layers like PECVD or thermal evaporation or HWCVD, like that. Many techniques are there, but we are not going to into details. So we will discuss about how this will work. Okay. Now, if you draw the band diagram here, so this is the interface. Okay, this is the Okay, this is the interface between P and N type semiconductor. Okay, at the equilibrium condition, the Fermi level is constant throughout the semiconductor. Okay, throughout the semiconductor. We know for p-type semiconductor, Fermi level is close to the valence band, and for it is conduction band is away from the valence band. For n-type semiconductor, the conduction band is close to the Fermi level, and this is valence band is away from the Fermi level. Okay. This is the general energy levels of p and n-type semiconductor. Okay. Now, so you just join this one, and you will get the band bending diagram. You will get the band bending diagram. Okay, now see here we have free electrons in the conduction band. This is EC and this is EV, and this is the in thermal equilibrium condition, but we are applying our device in reverse bias condition, so the depletion width also increases. And also here see, suppose this is the band diagram and the our depletion width increases. So if you remove this one again, I will read on this one. So, like this we have, so here is the, so Fermi level, and this here also some Fermi level, just I will drive it. So this is the conduction band, and this is the valence band. Okay, this is the depletion region, and this is the Fermi level for n-type, and this is the p-type, and p-type, n-type, this is EC and EF and EB. Okay, this is EC, EF, N. This is n-type and p-type, this is the interface. See here, when you give the reverse bias voltage here, see, if we have give reverse bias voltage, what happens in reverse bias condition, here electrons, p-type holes are the majority carrier. In n-type, electrons are the, you know, p-type holes are the majority carrier, right? Here holes are there in the valence band. Here free electrons are there, right? So because of this reverse bias condition, what happens? This here depletion width will increase, and the depletion width direction is here negative charge and negative this one, and negative ionization, this is positive ionization. The electric field direction is negative to positive to negative. This is internal electric field. When you applied external biasing voltage, the internal field, external electric field in the junction will increase. Why? Because here we are applying some external reverse bias voltage. Okay, the electric field will increase. That means what? Here, whatever minority carrier holds in this semiconductor, minority electrons are the majority carrier in n-type semiconductor, holes are the minority carrier in n-type semiconductor. This minority carrier holes in n-type semiconductor will drift towards the p region. So holes are drifting from n to p, and electrons, minority electrons in p-type semiconductor, these are minority carrier electrons, will drift towards the n-type semiconductor. Here these minority electrons in p-type semiconductor drifting by electric field to n-type semiconductor. Once these electrons comes from p to n-type, here becoming a majority carriers. Electrons are minority carrier in p-type. Once they come into n-type, they are becoming a majority carrier. Similarly, holes also n-type semiconductor, minority, once they come into p-type, they are becoming a majority carrier. So that using reverse bias condition, only holes are coming to p-side and electrons coming to n-type. So that we are reducing the recombination losses in a semiconductor a junction. Okay. Only holes are coming to the p-side and only electrons are coming to the n-side using by internal electric field. We are increasing internal electric field by reverse bias condition. Minority carrier electrons in n-type are coming to the p-side and minority holes are coming to the n-side, so that only one type of charge carriers coming to only one direction. Okay, that means holes are coming p-type, minority carrier holes are coming p-type and electrons are coming to the n-side, so that only one type charge carrier moving one side and other charge carriers moving opposite direction. See here holes are moving upside and the electrons are moving n-side, so that we can connect electrons at backside electrode and holes we can connect at front side electrode, so that we can collect the electricity or we can collect the charge flow. We can collect the charge flow, that is current. So using photons, we are extracting the sub electrons or current. That is the working of solar cell. Now we will see the characteristics of solar cell. Okay, we will see the characteristics of solar cell. So first we will draw the IV characteristics. First we will draw the IV characteristics. Okay, this is the solar cell. This is voltage and this is the current. This is voltage and current. So the diagram is IV characteristics like this. Here very less current will be there. So it will start like this. So this is dark characteristics. What is that? Dark characteristics. So that means we are not shedding light here, only it act as a simple p-n junction diode. When you shine the light, more number of electrons holes will be. So here also, if you shine light here, more number of electrons holes will be generated, right? If you shine light here, some light is shining here, right? If you shine the light here, electron holes are generating. These electron holes are separating immediately by this internal electric field. So holes only going this direction and electrons going to the n side, n-type semiconductor. So whatever we are using the light and generating electron holes, and these generated electron holes we are using internal electric field to separate these electrons. So this, because of this electric field, only holes are drifting towards the p side and electrons drifting towards the n side, and so that we are collecting electron holes separately. So that here also, so when you shine the, without shining light, it is act as a simple diode. Okay, if you shine the light, more number of electron holes will be generated, the current flow will increase, number of charge carrier will increase, that time the curve will be comes down like this. This is under light condition. This is first one is under dark and second one is under light condition. So okay, here we will discuss about solar parameters. What is that? Solar parameters. These are the main characteristic features of parameters to decide the efficiency working of the solar cell. That is, first one, So short circuit current or short circuit current. This is voltage. This is the short circuit current ISC. This is open circuit voltage VOC. And if you draw this one, here you will get the power maximum. That is maximum power point MPP. Here we will. Why we are getting in the fourth quadrant means we are extracting the power from solar cell. Okay. This is the short circuit current means. Short circuit current ISC is equal. Okay. So first before that we will write the current equation. Okay. I illumination or light equation is equal the dark current plus here two currents are involved. One is dark and is photo. Okay, photo. So here the dark current is always opposite to the photo current. That means you can write here I dark minus I photo. So what is the dark equation? You can write I zero exponential QV by NKT. Here you can write minus 1 minus IPH. This is the current equation from the total light illuminated or light condition. Illuminated and light condition I is equal to I zero exponential QV by NKT minus 1 into minus is equal to minus IPH. IPH. Okay, IPH. IPH. So we'll write the short circuit conditions and this thing. Just a second, please. So short circuit condition. What happens when short circuit condition means maximum current flows through the solar cell. Maximum current flows through the solar cell. That is ISC is equal to the IPH. That is photo current. This is the I photo current. This is the I photo current. The maximum current flows through the device. That means when you short the device or when you short the terminals, maximum current flows through the device. That is the short circuit current. Now open circuit voltage. Open circuit voltage. Open circuit voltage. Open circuit voltage. VOC. Or you can write VOC. VOC means when device is open. That means we have opened the device. So once you open the device, maximum voltage drops across the device. That is the open circuit voltage. That time no current flows in the device. When short circuit current, there is no voltage. Okay. So that means I illumination equal to 0. I illumination becomes 0. Right? In that case, what happens from this equation? I 0 exponential e to the power of QV by KT and R NKT minus 1 equal to IPH. Right? IPH. This is the equation. From this equation, so VEG becomes VOC. From this equation, you can write Q VOC by NKT is equal IPH by, this is I0 is common to both them, IPH by I0 plus 1, okay, plus 1 here, so we will rewrite this equation. So VOC is equal, you can write NKT by Q into ln of IPH by I0. You can neglect one term because this IPH by I0 is maximum. So this is the VOC. Next one is fill factor. Fill factor indicates the IP power maximum by ISC into short circuit current density into open circuit voltage. This is the I maximum. This is equal to V maxima, this one, and this is the I maxima. The square of the curve, it will expand. I maxima, V maxima by ISC into VOC. ISC into VOC, this is the fill factor. Fill factor is high, efficiency is there. Efficiency means power, extracted output power for incident input power, P in. P out for P input. Whatever extracted power for incident photons, that is the efficiency. So efficiency depends on all these parameters: short circuit current density, fill factor, and open circuit voltage. Or you can write this one FF into VOC and ISC by P input power. the input power means from the whatever radiation from the sun. Okay, this is the efficiency formula, you can take percentage. So this is the our solar cell parameters. So this is the, when you shine the light, electron holes will be generated. These electron holes will be separated by internal electric field, and after separation we will collect the this charge gather, that is the working of simple solar cell. Okay, using this solar cell parameters, short circuit current, open circuit voltage and fill factor efficiency, we can determine the how efficiently the solar panels or solar cells are working. We can estimate using these parameters. Okay, this is about solar cells. Okay, thank you.